السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، طلاب الفرقة الرابعة قسم إدارة الأعمال برنامج اللغة الإنجليزية مادة Small Business. Today we are going to talk about choosing a form of ownership. By the ending of this video, you will be able to understand the factors you should put in your consideration before you start a business. Second, the forms of ownership. Each form of ownership has its own unique set of advantages and disadvantages. The key to choosing the right form of ownership is the ability to understand the characteristics of each type and knowing how they affect entrepreneur, business, and personal circumstances. There are some factors you should put in your consideration before you decide to start small business. Number one, tax consideration. Number one, tax considerations. Because of the advanced tax rates under each form of ownership, the government's constant repairing the tax code and the year-to-year fluctuation in the company income, entrepreneur should calculate the firm's tax bill under each ownership form every year. Number two, liability exposure. Certain forms of ownership offer business owners greater protection from personal liability due to financial problems and some problems for products and a host of other difficulties. Number three, startup capital requirements. Forms of ownership differ in their ability to raise startup capital. Number four, control. Entrepreneurs must decide early on how much control they are willing to sacrifice in exchange for help from other people in building successful business. Number five, managerial ability. If entrepreneur lacks skills or experience in certain areas, he or she may need to select a form of ownership that allows him or her to bring into the company people who have those skills and experience. Business goals. The main goal of any business to achieve some profits. So, entrepreneur should select the best form to achieve his or her profit. Management succession plans. Some forms of ownership make this transition much smoother than others, or after the owner dies, who comes after him? Cost of formation. Some forms of ownership are much more costly and involved to create than others. Entrepreneurs must weigh carefully the benefits and the cost the particular form they choose. Business owners have some major forms of ownership, as you can see from this diagram. You can realize from this diagram, are you okay with being personally liable for business debts? If you said yes, you have this way to follow. If you said no, you have another way to follow. If you said yes, do you want to file business taxes in your personal return or file business taxes separately? If you said personal, if you said another option, separate according to tax. If you said personal, are you starting your business alone or with partners? You have two options here. Alone, you have one form, sole proprietorship. If you said partner, will your partner be active in your business or no? If you said active, general partners or general partnership. If you said not active, just investor, you have another form, limited partnership. If you said separate according to file tax, Are you starting your business alone or with partner? If you said alone, you have LLC, which means limited liability company. If you said partner, you have limited liability partnership or LLC. If you said no, do you want to raise your capital or issue stock? If you said yes, you have corporation company. If you said no, do you already have or plan to hire employees? If you said yes, you have LLC. If you said no, and are you starting your business alone or with partnership? If you said alone, you have LLC. If you said partner, you have limited liability partnership or LLC. This just summarize the forms of business owner. We can realize from this figure the forms of ownership according to percentage of business. The first type, sole proprietorship, 71.9%. Second one is corporations, 12.6. Third one, C corporation, 6.4. Number four, limited liability companies, LLC, 5.3. Limited partnership, sorry, general partnership, 2.3. Last one, limited partnership, 1.4. There are six forms of ownership: sole proprietorship, partnership, corporation, S corporation, limited liability company, venture, joint venture. In this topic, we discuss three points: the definition of each form, the advantage and the disadvantages of each one. First, the sole proprietorship is a business owned and managed by one individual. There are some advantages for them. Simple to create. An attractive feature of proprietorship is the ease and the speed of its formation. Entrepreneur can complete all the necessary steps, maybe online or just a few hours, he can complete the creation of this business. Least costly form of ownership to establish. The sole proprietorship is generally the least expensive form of ownership to establish comparing with other forms. Profit incentives. The owner, after he paid all company expenses, he will take the rest of money as profit. Total decision making authority. He just only the person he has authority to take any decision, and he has ability to respond quickly to the changes. No special legal restriction comparing with other forms. Easy to discontinue. If he decides to discontinue operation, it is easy for him to stop the business quickly. There are also some disadvantages. One, unlimited personal liability. The sole proprietor is personally liable for all the business debts, the suppliers or debtors can take their money from his personal financial. Number two, limited access to capital. It is not easy for them to increase their capital. If they decided to increase the capital from the loans, maybe they found some difficulties comparing with other forms. Limited skills and ability. He just only the person who has ability to run this business. He has limited skills, also knowledge. Feelings of isolation. He spent a lot of time in his business because he just only own and manage this business. He feels as isolation. Lack of continuity for the business. If he dies or retires, the business automatically stopped. In this slide, I would like to confirm that if the assets of this company not enough to pay the money for creditors, according to the law, which gives the authority or the right to creditors to take the money from personal assets. The second form of the ownership, partnership. What is partnership? A partnership is an association of two or more people who co-own a business for a profit. In a partnership, the co-owners or partners share the business assets, liabilities, and the profits according to the terms of previously established partnership agreement. The standard partnership agreement will likely include the following: the name of partnership, the purpose of this business, home of the business, where will the principal business be located, duration of partnership, how long will the partnership last, name the partners and their legal address, contribution of each one, agreement on how the profit or loss will be distributed, agreement on salary or drawing rights against the profit for each partner, sale of partnership interest, absence or disability of one of the partnership, voting rights, and many information should be in the agreement. Also, we have some rights and duties of partners. The right to participate in the management and of business, the right to an accounting, duty of loyalty, duty of obedience, duty of care, duty of inform. There are some advantages of partnership. One, easy to establish. Like proprietorship, the partnership is easy and inexpensive to establish. Complementary skills. In successful partnership, the parts, skills, and the abilities complement each other. Division for profit. The partnership agreement should articulate the nature of each partner contribution and the proportional share of the profits. Large pool of capital. The partnership form of ownership can significantly broaden the pool of capital available to a business. Undercapitalization is a common cause of business failure. Ability to attract limited partners. Every partnership must have at least one general partner, and I give you more details about general partners next slide. Minimal governmental regulation, less than the corporation. More flexibility. Partnership can generally act quickly to changing market conditions. Taxation. The partners like proprietorship avoid the double taxation. Types of partners. General partners. Second one, limited partners. First, general partners take an active role in managing a business, have unlimited liability for partnership debts. Every partner must have at least one general partner. Second, limited partners can't participate in the day-to-day management of the company, have limited liability for partnership debts. You can see from this slides, according to partnership, the form of ownership, claims of partnership creditors. They have two sources to take their money. According to general partners, they can take their money from firm assets If this not enough, they will take their money from personal assets of general partners. The disadvantages of partnership. Number one, unlimited liability, at least one partner. At least one member of every partnership must be a general partner. The general partner has unlimited personal liability, even though he is often the partner with the least personal resources. Number two, capital accumulation. It is generally not as effective as the corporate form of ownership, which can raise capital by selling shares of ownership to outside investors. Difficulty in disposing of partnership interest without dissolving the partners. Often, a partner is required to sell his interest to the remaining partner, even if the original agreement contains such a requirement and clearly defines how the value of each partner ownership will be determined. There are no guarantee that the other partner will have financial resources to buy the selling interest. Lack of continuity. Partners can make provisions in the partnership agreement to avoid dissolution. Due to death, if all parties agree to accept as partners those who inherit the debt interest. Potential for personality and authority conflict. Being a partnership much like being married, making sure partners' work, habits, goals, ethics, and general business philosophy are compatible in an important step in avoiding a nasty business divorce. Last one, partners bound by the law of agency. The third type of ownership, corporation. Corporation is a separate legal entity from its owners. There are many types of corporations. Domestic, a corporation doing business in the state in which it is incorporated. Foreign, a corporation rented in one state and doing business in another state. Alliance, a corporation formed in another country but doing business in the United States. Publicly held, corporation that has large number of shareholders and whose stock usually is traded on one of the large stock exchange. Closely held, corporation in which shares are controlled by relatively small number of people, often called family members, relatives, or friends. This type of ownership called corporation, the creditors, they have just only one way to take their money from corporation assets, not allow for them to take any money from shareholders' personal assets. Advantages of corporation. First, limited liability of stockholders. Creditors, they have right to take their money from or corporation capital and not allow for them to take any money from personal assets. Ability to attract capital. Corporation have proved to be the most effective form of ownership for accumulating a large amount of capital. Ability to continue indefinitely, unless limited by its charter. Corporation is a separate legal entity and can continue indefinitely. Transferable ownership. If stockholders so desire, they may transfer their shares through sale or bequeath to someone else. The disadvantages of corporation: cost and the time of incorporating. Creating corporation can cost between $500 and $300. Double taxation: the stockholders, they will pay tax twice. First, the overall the company will pay tax on the profit. Then each stockholder will pay money or tax on their profit. Potential for diminished managerial incentives. You know, the ownership, they have no time to run this business. They rent or give the authority for manager to run this business, and they have no the same degree interest or loyalty to the company. Last one, legal requirements and regulation red tape. A joint venture. To understand this type of business, we assume that we have a project and we need a company or more to perform this project. Unfortunately, there is no project, no company has enough resources to perform this project. So more than one decided to join together to perform this project. A joint venture here is a business entity created by two or more parts, generally characterized by shared ownership, shared returns and risk, and shared governance. Finally, we covered today some topics related to the form of the ownership, and we distinguish between four forms, just to focus on these forms and ignore the rest, because these forms not exist in our environment. Thank you very much. See you next video.